My name is Melitta Schachner, and my research is on adhesion molecules. That's the overall designation of the molecules I work with. And they are fascinating molecules in the sense that they make cells recognize each other, enforce their relationship, or not enforce their relationships, during ontogenetic development, and that is embryonic development. But it's fascinating also that they play important roles in the adult nervous system that is under pressure to regenerate. Mammals can do that to quite some extent, but we've become very interested in an animal that is better in regeneration than us humans, namely fish, zebrafish. And the zebrafish is very interesting in the sense that it can regenerate completely after you cut the spinal cord. You have an adult zebrafish, let's say that big, you cut the spinal cord, and then within 6 weeks after the injury, swims as happily as before, and as we say, as a fish in water. Now, how can we learn from zebrafish to apply that to mouse and man? These molecules you put into an injured mouse, and lo and behold, many of the molecules identified to be beneficial in zebrafish, applied to, in that respect, not intelligent mouse, it regenerates better. So this is the first step towards going to the human, right? And the application in human therapy, and the application of the molecule, we'd like to reduce them to their essential smaller parts. And those we are reducing again to even smaller molecules. The next step in my research is to see which type of beneficial molecules we can put together in a combinatorial approach to make spinal cord regeneration better. We very much hope for companies to get interested in our compounds and have them patented such that they can license them and make them available. The older I get, the more I want to see that my fellow persons, right? It sounds a little bombastic that mankind doesn't suffer so much in terms of nervous system diseases. This really drives me on, having come from really basic science. Dedicated basic scientist, I suddenly learned that the molecules we are working with are not only good in embryonic development to make a healthy nervous system, that these molecules play important roles in the adult. I like to say that whatever is good for the spinal cord in mammalian regeneration is beneficial for other parts of the brain that get hurt. For instance, in stroke, Parkinson's, Huntington's, Alzheimer's, there are many more nervous system diseases which all have to be cured with good molecules and good cells.